What is up, y'all? It's the Eric V, your stream teach here. And ever since I hit puberty, I've been told that I have a voice for radio. So what I'm going to show you today is how to become your favorite radio host on your live streams. We are going to use a technique called audio ducking to make your audio respect you. And I'm going to give you a preview of what you're about to learn right now. What is up, y'all? You have tuned into the Eric V's Streamer School. This is a brand new episode on audio ducking and how to make sure your audio gets out of the way when you come a walking. And what you'll notice is that when I stop speaking, my audio comes back up, and when I start speaking, it gets out of the way. So I'm going to stop speaking now, and you're going to notice it rise up. You want to know how to do that? Let's get into it. Class is in session. All right, y'all. This is what I call showing your audio who's boss. We are going to implement this audio ducking. So let's get into it. Your desktop audio. You can see right now in OBS. By the way, I'm recording in Streamlabs, but I'm showing you OBS just so you know how to do it in OBS. In Streamlabs, it's the exact same way. After we do the effects, I'm gonna turn it on in Streamlabs so you can hear the effect in action. So right now, as you can see, the music is in the red zone and my voice is also in the red zone. So that means these two audio sources are battling each other. And again, I'm about to show that music who is boss, because it's my stream. We're going to click on that gear on desktop audio or whatever your audio source is. We're clicking on filters. After we click on filters, we are clicking on the plus sign and we are adding a compressor. And then we can call that ducking. Please don't make a typo. There might be a parent or guardian over your shoulder. I don't want to get you in trouble. We're going to click OK, and I'm going to drag that up a little bit just so you can see the effects of these things happening live. So again, you still see the music is up in the upper yellow, still battling me while my own mic is peaking, but you're not listening to OBS. You're listening to Streamlabs. So the audio should sound fine to you. The first thing I'm going to do is add the sidechain ducking source. And what that means is what your audio is getting out of the way of. And since I want it to get out of the way of my voice, that sidechain ducking source is the microphone slash aux. So whatever you name your microphone, that's what it's going to be. We're going to leave the ratio at 10 to 1. That's basically how quiet the audio gets based on when the filter hears you. If you want to switch it to 5 to 1, that's normally what I game in. But since I'm listening to music for the purpose of this video, I'm going to keep it at 10 to 1. Our threshold is basically when the audio kicks in. So when my microphone goes over the negative 30 decibel threshold, which we will implement right now, that compressor will kick in to make the audio duck. And you can already see the ducking is working, but it's not as intense as I want it to be because the music is still a little bit overbearing and it's coming back really quickly, kind of mid-sentence. So what we're going to do is increase our attack. And what our attack is how fast it takes for that filter to kick in. We're going to set that to 4, if I can, there it is. And we're going to set our release to 650. Release is when it lets go. Attack is obviously when it attacks. Think of it like a dog, I guess. But yeah, 650 milliseconds is when it lets go and when that filter stops doing its thing. So as you can tell right now, as I'm speaking, the audio is staying down in the green area. So that audio is now respecting me because I set the filters up the way I needed it to. So right now I'm going to shut up and you're going to see that audio kick back up into the yellow, maybe into the red a little bit. And that's all there is to it. So I'm going to let you hear that effect live. But again, look at it right here. And again, as my audio drops below that negative 30, that desktop audio knows, okay, now I can go because daddy's done talking. And that's how you want your audio to be. So I'm going to let you listen to what this sounds like on my end, just so you hear what I'm listening to and just so you can hear that effect. Mm-hmm. What is up, y'all? This is the Eric V, your stream teach here. Make sure you check out my YouTube channel, but you're already here. So you can check out my Twitch channel. You can check out Instagram. You can check out Twitter to see my thoughts if I decide to share them. But anyway, as you can tell, that audio is ducking just the way it should. And I'm going to stop talking. You're going to hear that thing kick right back up. Even though the song ended right as I was speaking, but it did get louder. But I'm going to give it a little bit more time just so you can notice it one more time. You see? You did a good job. This should save you a lot of time. And I'm going to close out this video on this smooth jazz presented by Khoi Kid. I want to give a special shout out to Epos Vox for those specific settings that I use for my own compressing and sidechain ducking. He has a great YouTube channel. Feel free to check him out. But if you want to check me out on Twitch, feel free to check the Eric V Monday, Wednesday, Friday, or any old school Saturday to ask me any question that you want. Feel free to join my Discord. We have a channel for all things streamer school. Ask anything you need to know, and I got your back. And if I don't, somebody in the community does. This has been the Eric V, and this class is dismissed.
Beautiful, yes. Sexy tan, and look at her fanny there. You
fanny! Look at her fanny! Ah, big fat fanny!